University of Wyoming, who has been looking through our strata to see how many pollen grains we have and whether or not it's sufficient pollen to really get an idea of pollen communities through time. Good news, yes. So the Pleistocene has enough pollen in it that we're really going to be able to tell what the community structure was like. And the cool thing is it looks pretty different. So if you notice here, there is a juniper. That's because currently a natural trap cave is high desert, very dry, very windy. And so it's mostly juniper, sage, and some grasses. But the stuff that we're getting out of the Pleistocene looks herbaceous. So it looks like it is actually a pretty different community back then. And so we're really excited to be able to get a record of the plants near Natural Trout Cave from all the way from the last glacial maximum to the Holocene. So that's about 21,000 years ago. So the exciting part, maybe, yeah, vertebrate communities. So there's a couple of different questions that we have to ask first about vertebrate communities before we can get to the community part of the community. So we've been, right now we're working on what species are we finding at Natural Trap Cave, and then we're hoping to get to questions like, so if we're looking at the megafauna, can we determine whether or not the megafauna went extinct gradually or abruptly? What does this tell us about causes of megafaunal extinction? And maybe how did, and this is the question that I'm most interested in addressing, how did the rest of the ecosystem respond when the megafauna started going extinct? So in terms of megafauna, we find a lot of really cool megafauna at the cave. We have found one mammoth in the previous excavations, but we don't find a lot of mammoth. We don't find a lot of cave bear, but they're definitely there. We do find a fair bit of American lion, which is a very large lion. Our, maybe one of our most abundant duos or trios, in fact, are American cheetahs, which are quite a bit larger than African cheetahs and probably a different cat group. But they have that same running type of morphology. We also have a lot of antelopes and a whole lot of bighorn sheep. We have this impression that all these cheetahs are chasing these bighorn sheep and antelope on the landscape, and like they're all running so fast they don't notice the hole, because seriously, this is the most abundant taxa that we get in the Pleistocene, are these cheetahs and antelopes. We also get a lot of American horse, which are different than the European horses that live in North America today. They're extinct at the Pleistocene. Bison and antiquus, so we get the very large bison. We get American camels, also very large species, and we get fairly abundant in the cave as well. And here's some of the megafauna laid out for identification in lab, not my lab. But yeah, you can see we're getting really beautiful specimens. And because of the fact, like I said, it's 40 degrees Fahrenheit in there, so it's basically a refrigerator. And it keeps these bones really pristine, and it maintains the ancient DNA, which I'll talk about a little bit later. And the isotopes, so like, there keeps it fairly
strong. Is there any evidence that scavengers worked on those bones?
I have seen no evidence of scavengers on megafauna. Some of the microfauna have a little bit of gnaw marks from wood rats, which I'll talk about a little later. But no, I haven't noticed any scavenging on them.
You didn't discuss it, but does this cave have any other entrance but the hole?
Well, we are pretty sure there's some small cracks that rodents can get in and out of, but no other entrance, no human-sized entrance.
But you said it was a sinkhole. I was wondering how.
Yeah. So it's from water base water levels or groundwater. That's the word. Groundwater being higher than it is today, ate out the center portion of the cave, and then large portions of the ceiling collapsed. So it's actually a very large dome cave in a very traditional sense. We have done an extensive amount of mapping in the cave at this point, and we haven't found any other entrances yet. So.
Nobody was hungry enough to go in the hole.
Oh no. There would be no climbing out. Mm-hmm. So there's no evidence of humans. There's little bits of charcoal that we're pretty sure are natural that kind of seem to wash in. But we haven't seen any evidence of even chip stones, like stones, anything. Even though there are archaeological sites nearby, but no obvious use of the cave. So this is Julie Meechan. She's one of the lead scientists at the cave. And this is Ian, who's one of our cavers, who's been really helpful throughout over the years, over the last several years.